I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
It just makes sense, and I'm glad it came at the perfect time.
Eddie, I'm not sure if Joe DeGuardia is here, but Danny and Demetrius Andre have history. Never fought them, and previously in the amateurs and things of that nature. Mm-hmm. Start boxing, you just come co-promoter the show with them. How feasible is that fight taking place?
Yeah, again, no disrespect to Demetrius Andrade, and I put Charlo in the same bracket as well, and I put Saunders in the bracket and Lemieux in the bracket. I see Danny Jacobs as a level beyond those guys. Doesn't mean we won't fight them, because they're very good fighters, but we're really trying to establish ourselves as the major name in the division, and that's why I said about the three, because I really feel like there is a three, and that is Canelo, Golovkin and Danny Jacobs. That's, for me, the big three in the division. Doesn't mean we won't fight Andrade, Charlo, Lemieux, but you know, our plan is to be in the mix with those guys. So, you know, we want to make sure that we are up there as a brand, as a fighter, you know. So, yeah, Andrade. At the end of that, I don't decide who Danny Jacobs fights. You know, we'll speak to the network, then we'll sit down with Keith, we'll put it forward to Danny and the training team, and ultimately they'll make a decision. But we're doing our own thing. We're not really chasing anyone in particular. We're going to do our own thing.
Eddie, before the fight, you said if Jarrell Miller beat Marius Wach convincingly or impressively, you might be in line for an Anthony Joshua shot. After tonight, where you...
It was a good win. I mean, this is the Danny press conference, but, you know, Marius Wach, TKO 9, is a very, very solid scribe on a heavyweight's career. You know, he's been beaten a couple of times by top-level guys, Vladimir Klitschko, Povetkin. These are top. And Jarrell wore him down. I think Jarrell has a lot of learning to do. I think he shouldn't be stepping in just yet. He needs one or two more before he gambles. And again, I'd like to see him bank the money. You know, this is a tough sport. Bank the money before you gamble. And that's what Jarrell Miller needs to do. He needs to come back. I'd love him to box on our card in April. He's from Brooklyn as well. You know, he's an exciting heavyweight. He would have learned so much fighting the likes of Marius Wach. But again, Marius Wach, TKO 9. Is a very, very impressive win and puts him probably one or two steps away from fighting for the World Heavyweight title.
Danny.
Did you notice Arias favoring his foot because he said he had a blister on his sock?
Oh, he had a blister now?
No, he really does. I mean, I think he does, yeah.
Oh, he did? Oh, okay.
Yeah. Those pesky blisters.
Oh, man.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe if he didn't run, didn't, or if he met me in the middle, he wouldn't have had surgery on it.
Danny,
much respect to
him. He actually left with his foot in a splint. It was on top of the foot.
Yeah, man, listen. You know, at the end of the day, it speaks for itself. Yeah.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. EsNews. He came a long way. All the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind. Competition, he abusing them.